Praise the Lord, church. I'd like to welcome everyone back to another online service. As the pastor says, hope that everyone's staying saved and safe. Just like to go over a few quick announcements for everyone. Remember, if you have any prayer requests, names added to the prayer list, or any praise reports, please send those to cljcrequests@gmail.com. Since we're unable to pass around the fasting calendar, please continue up to do your normal dates. If you're feeling extra generous, you know, throw a few extra meals on there. Well, we need fasting 24/7 during this time. Remember when all of our videos drop, it's 8 a.m. on YouTube for Sundays, 10 a.m. on Facebook for Sunday service. Brother Thomas's lessons on Wednesdays are available on Wednesday at 5 p.m. on both platforms, as well as our Sunday school lessons that drop on Friday night are available on YouTube and Facebook at 5 p.m. Just want to continue to let everyone know that while we're down here, we're continuing to pray over the names in the box, the soldiers, everything that the elders prayed for when we had service. We're continuing to pray for those things, and also the pastor is continuing to read out the names on the prayer list, and he's continuing to pray for them daily. Lastly, we just want to continue to thank everyone that makes this possible. Thank the choir for the songs. Thank Brandon Need for opening their house up to me. Thank for everyone that gets the messages ready. Those are down here recording. Everyone that edits, uploads, and any part that you played in this, we just want to thank everyone. We thank the pastor for trusting us to do this, and most of all, we want to thank God for making this possible. So, if you guys need anything, need help with anything, need someone to talk to, just if you need anything at all, just reach out to us. Call, text, email, stop by, whatever it is. We love you guys, we want to help you, and we hope to see you soon. Thank you.
Yeah. Good morning, church. Hope everybody's staying saved and safe. Hope you had a good Thanksgiving and you didn't eat too much, and a good weekend, good extended weekend, hopefully, for most of you, and hope you're doing all right. I ask you to continue to remember all of our prayer requests and fasting schedule and stuff, and remember sending your prayer requests to the web, to the email address that we always provide to you. Again, as Jonathan says, you can back up and find those. Just a real quick note on our Christmas holiday schedule. It's hard to believe we're already talking about Christmas now. I was kind of joking with Larry J, talked to him this week, and he was like, well, if I don't talk to you again before Thanksgiving, have a good Thanksgiving. I was like, well, if I don't talk to you before Thanksgiving, Christmas, and New Year's, have a good Christmas, New Year's, and Thanksgiving. So it's just hard to believe all this. We're already looking at all this now, thinking about these things. We should be thinking about the Christmas plays and dinners and stuff, but we're not. But for Christmas, on Wednesday the 23rd and Friday the 25th, I think, which is Christmas, we will not be dropping services that week. On the 23rd and 25th, we will be on both Sundays, but not on the 23rd and the 25th, just to give all of us guys that's been down here this whole time, giving us kind of a break on that week and stuff, so allowing us a little bit of time to, so I guess it's a one service Sunday there or whatever, week or whatever, so, but we'll get back to the normal schedule once we're there. So if you have your Bibles with you, if you want to get them out, you can. If not, we'll have them up on the screen. Deuteronomy 17, if you would take your Bibles, chapter 7, verses 17 through 18. If thou shalt say in thine heart, these nations are more than I, how can I dispossess them? Thou shalt not be afraid of them, but shalt well remember what the Lord thy God did unto Pharaoh and unto all Egypt. And then Deuteronomy 8 and 11. Beware that thou forget not the Lord thy God in keeping his commandments and his judgments and his statutes, which I command thee this day. And then Judges 8 and 34. And the children of Israel remembered not the Lord their God, who had delivered them out of the hands of all of their enemies on every side. And then Psalms 20 and 7. Some trust in chariots and some in horses, but I will remember the name of the Lord our God. I want to speak to you, preach to you, whatever, this morning on just this thought for a little bit. Roll back the curtains. Roll back the curtains. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you today for your mercies and grace and all the things that you've done for us, God. We just ask you, Lord, to strengthen our church, God. Strengthen your people, God. Just bless us. Just continue to bless us, God. You blessed us so much, God. I haven't missed a meal payment of anything that I didn't want to, Lord. And I appreciate you, God. And I don't know very many people, if anybody in our church that needs anybody, anything. And you know, God, if they need something, God, you know the pastor would help them to provide that for them, God. God, we thank you for the blessings that you've given us. God, we thank you for the provisions and the protections, Lord. God, we ask you continue to provide for us and to protect us and watch over us and keep us, Lord. God, bless this message. God, bless my voice. God, anoint my voice. God, let the words be your words. Let it come from your heart and not my heart, and from your mind and not my mind, God. We ask of you, Lord, today to bless it, God, to anoint it, God, to stir, to strengthen, to encourage the people, God. We ask you to touch this virus, Lord Jesus, God. We ask you, Lord, just kind of, God, keep it down, Lord Jesus. Jesus, God, just I know, Lord, that you can make it go away with just a thought, Lord. So we ask you, but we ask you, Lord, also to remember all of our doctors and police officers and firefighters and EMTs, ambulance drivers, that you would watch over and keep them and protect them. Watch over the church, keep us, protect us, God. We know some people's had it, Lord, but we know that you've watched over them and you protected them, you've kept them, Lord Jesus, God, and they're healthy again, Lord. We just ask you to do this, God. We give you praise. Thank you, Lord, for all that you've done. Praise, church. Just take a moment and thank the Lord right there in your house, wherever you might be this morning, while you're listening. God, we thank you and we praise you, Lord. God, we glorify you, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Lord, so much, God. God, we give you praise. God, we give you glory for it, Lord. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. And you may be seated if you're standing. If you're not, you can stay seated then. Roll back the curtains. At work, I have a calendar that I have specific dates that are listed on. And each Christmas, as I get a new calendar, Brenda usually, I just ask her, one of the things I always ask for is just a new calendar. It's just pretty simple, but always just, you know, she'll get me a Pittsburgh Steelers calendar or something like that. And each Christmas, once I get that new calendar, I begin to take everything that I have written on the old calendar, and I begin to carry it over to the new calendar. I have people's birthdays, I have anniversaries, I have work anniversaries. I have some, for the past 3 or 4 years, I don't know why I do it, but I've begun to document what the first frost that we would have. I have the days that we have the first frost, whether it's a light frost, heavy frost. I'm not sure why I do it. I just got in the habit of doing it. So I've got things like that, just all kinds of information so that I can go back and I can look at it. And I can remember it. I can see it, and it makes me remember. There are people's birthdays on there that I have met through work that I don't even talk to anymore that are still on there, and I have their birthdays on there, and I just don't have the heart to take them off. I don't have the heart to take their names off there. So when I see their name on there, I remember them, and I remember the relationship that we might have had, whatever it was, and it just may be the only time I ever think of them throughout the whole year. So it just kind of allows me to remember, to see that name and remember them and remember the relationship we have. When we came home from work in March, I left that calendar there at work thinking, you know, well, we'll be back in a couple of weeks. This will only be a month or so, and then I'll be back and I won't miss any days, you know. And then I got furloughed and I really didn't even think about it. And here we are 8-9 months later, and we're still not back to work. And I actually went this past week and got that calendar. And who knows how many dates that I have missed on there, people's birthdays and anniversaries and other things. And I forgot to write that. I didn't get to write down the first day that we had frost on there. And so I've missed birthdays and things. And because not everybody's on Facebook. I know that's probably might come to a surprise. Some people, or I might not be connected to them. Maybe everybody's on there and I'm just not connected to them anyway. But in this current situation that we're in, and in all of the quarantines and not being able to go out and do the things that we normally do, it's nice to hear from people from time to time on their birthdays and such. It's nice to have somebody to remember you. It's nice to know that even for just a moment during the day, they thought about you and they took the time to text you or to type a message and just say, happy birthday, happy anniversary, happy first day of frost for the day, with that, from year 2017, whatever it might have been. I was looking at that calendar today and I noticed it was November the 7th was the day that me and Kirk both killed a buck together while we were hunting. It's the only time I've ever killed a deer with somebody else. And again, that's just some things that we remember, but it's nice to be able to, so when that happens, generally I'll text him a picture from that hunt or whatever. So it's just nice to have those reminders. It's nice to remember. And some of these reminders I have started to carry over to my phone, but not all of them. And so a couple of weeks ago, I had a reminder pop up on my phone that it was Paul Cass' birthday. And I'd already been texting him that morning. I had been working, and Paul had been sitting and waiting for a deer coming by. I don't know if you call that hunting or whatever, but he was sitting and waiting is what he was doing. And I guess maybe he wasn't really rubbing it in, but I would tell him that he was rubbing it in. And so as we had texted, and I had texted him a couple times, and all of a sudden it popped up, Paul Cass' birthday, and I was like, oh. So I texted him, and I said, oh, by the way, happy birthday. And I hadn't really forgotten. I can't say that I had forgotten that it was Paul's birthday, because I'd always depended on my phone or my calendar or whatever it was to remind me. I'd never committed it to my memory. So I can't say that I forgot it was his birthday. I'd never even committed it to my birthday. So you can't really forget something that you never committed it to. But it's not that it wasn't important. It's just that I put more trust in my phone than I do my memory sometimes getting older. So I had texted Brother Paul, you know, happy birthday. And so he texted back and he said, oh, thank you, I forgot. And I thought that was kind of odd. I mean, you have all the days and the birthdays and anniversaries, you might think, you know, you forgot your own birthday. You know, you needed a reminder about your own birthday. And I said, that's pretty odd. I'm pretty sure of all the days and birthdays, important days that are out there, I'm not going to forget my birthday. It's the anniversary of me. I mean, what better day could that be? I mean, think about that. It's the anniversary of Dwayne. Tim and Linda had a set of twins on December the 2nd, 1968. Darren got a great brother on December the 2nd, 1968. Sherry Lachatton got two wonderful brothers on December 2nd, 1968. Brenda's future husband was born on December 2nd, 1968. Heather and Nick's dad was born. He came into existence on December 2nd, 1968. And if it hadn't have been for him, that happened, they wouldn't have been here. What a day. You know, it's the anniversary of me. What more can you ask for? That's not a day I'm going to forget. It's not a day I'm going to let a lot of people forget. But Paul's anniversary of him, I would have thought he would remember that. But we're human. And as the song says, humans forget. So we need reminders from time to time. We need a string tied around our finger. We need a sticky note. We need a timer on the stove to remind us that, hey, that cake is ready. It's done to come out. We need a text from somebody once in a while to remind us that it's our birthday. I need reminders on conference calls from work. I need a reminder that it's my parents' anniversary. We're recording on Wednesday the 23rd. I guess today's the 23rd. Tomorrow's their anniversary. I got a reminder on my calendar for that. I think today's the 23rd. Okay, anyway, that's 26th is their anniversary, so I need a reminder for that. I need a reminder of when my sister-in-law Cindy's birthday is, because if I don't have these reminders, I might forget. I might not remember. I might not remember those things. So we need reminders, or we might miss out things on things that are important. We need reminders of God. We need reminders about God from time to time. And you say, well, no, Brother Dwayne. I would never forget about God. But have you ever forgotten your fast day? Have you ever forgotten that today, that hour, whatever it was your time to fast, and about the time you remembered, about the time you got three bites in, and all of a sudden, or whatever it was that you were doing that day, I'm fasting media, I'm fasting television, I'm fasting whatever it is. You know, if it was food and you get about three bites in, he's like, or maybe you forgot to pray and you're about five bites in and all of a sudden you're like, oh, I forgot to pray. I got to pray real quick. I've done that myself. I've heard people say, I forgot it was choir practice. I've heard people say, well, I forgot it was Friday night men's prayer service, or I forgot it was the first Saturday of the month. Those are important things to me. It's kind of like my birthday. I don't forget those things. I don't forget choir practice. I know Jonathan would like to at times, but I don't forget choir practice. I don't forget first Saturday night of the month. I don't forget men's prayer service. Those things are important to me. Those things are committed. I look for those days on the calendar, just like I know my parents' anniversary is coming up. I know what to look for. I know when it's the first Friday night of the month, I know it's time to start looking for that. I miss looking for that now. I know the first Saturday. I don't forget things that are important, but I have heard people say, I forgot. I don't remember that. We need reminders from time to time. I've seen people forget God. I forget about the things what God has done for them. It's like, well, Brother Dwayne, what do you mean by that? I mean, I've seen their lives, and I've seen the way they live, and they have forgotten where God has brought them from. They have forgotten where they could have been. They've forgotten what God has done for them. They have forgotten the healings, and they've forgotten the blessings, and they have forgotten the provisions. They have forgotten the strength. They have forgotten the deliverance. They've forgotten the salvation that God has provided for them. They have forgotten the blood that was shed for their salvation. They've forgotten the sacrifice. They have forgotten the stripes. They have forgotten the tears that Jesus shed. They have forgotten the things that Christ has done for them. And they have forgotten the sacrifice, again, that He has made for them through their lives, by the way that they are living their lives. They have forgotten promises that they have made to God. They've forgotten past conversations with God. They've forgotten that they said, God, I'll do this if you'll do that, and I'll do such and such, God, if you'll do such and such. God, I'll do whatever it takes, God, if you'll just heal me, if you'll just do whatever. I've seen people forget these things, but God has not. As I said in Friday night's Sunday school service that'll be coming up, we're recording, but it'll be playing this week on the Sunday school service. We talk about promises that may not have been kept, and we haven't kept our promises with God, but God's kept them. God has not forgotten them. God has gotten them written down. God has got those in His memory, because God does not forget. He will not forget. And God often sends you a reminder of things that you have forgotten. God will send you, and you better hope that God sends you little reminders of things you've gotten forgotten, little reminders. God told Israel, remember. God tells us, remember. He told Israel, He gave them reminders to remember. He gave them things to jog their memories, things to remind them to remember Him and to remember the things that He's done for them. Deuteronomy chapter 7, 17 through 21. Thou shalt say in thine heart, these nations are more than I. How can I dispossess them? Thou shalt not be afraid of them, but shalt well remember what the Lord thy God did unto Pharaoh and to all of Egypt, the great temptations which thine eyes saw, and the signs and the wonders. He told this to all throughout the time. They were supposed to remember this. And the wonders and the mighty hand and the stretched out arm whereby the Lord thy God brought thee out. So shall the Lord thy God do unto all the people of whom thou art. If you're afraid of them, that's what God's going to do to them. Moreover, the Lord thy God will send the hornet among them until they are left and hide themselves from thee to be destroyed. Thou shalt not be affrighted of them, for the Lord thy God is among you, a mighty God. God said, remember, I'm a mighty God and I'm a terrible God. You're making your way through the promised land and you see the enemies laying down in front of you and you begin to feel like I'm nothing, and we're seeing these giants and we're seeing them all up and we're nothing. We feel like there's no way that we can defeat them, God. There's no way I can get through my problems in the world, and I can't get over this, and I can't defeat pornography, and I can't defeat lust and tobacco and alcohol and drugs and whatever else it might be there. I can't defeat that things. God says, remember who you're serving. Remember who God was. Remember God delivered you through these things. Remember the Lord thy God, what he did to Pharaoh. Remember what he did unto Egypt. Remember the plagues that came on them, but they didn't touch you. Remember the frogs, and remember the lice, and remember the hell. Remember the death angel that came through the land and passed over you because it saw the blood. Remember leaving. Remember coming to the sea and how I parted it. Don't be afraid. Instead, remember. Instead of being afraid, remember what I've done for you. Remember the God that you serve. Remember what God has blessed you for. And remember, I am the same God. I am the same God. Remember what I did. And if I've done it before, I'll do it again. You've seen a thing or two. Now you know a thing or two. You've seen God do a thing or two. Remember, now God can do a thing or two. This morning, if you're worried about the situation that the world is in, if you're scared by what's happening, if the enemy in your life seems too big to defeat, remember. Remember God. Remember what God's brought you through in the past. Remember the times he's delivered you, and then the times when you've had the bad doctor report and all of a sudden you trusted God and it turned out to be good. Remember the times when the bills seemed to be too big to pay and you trusted God and God took care of it. Remember the times when you might have not had nothing, but you had God and that was more than enough. God was able to get you through. Remember the blessings. Remember the feeling the presence of God. Remember feeling the Holy Ghost. Remember that shout service. Remember that service when you danced all over the church. Remember God filling with you with the Holy Ghost. Remember the strength that you felt. Remember the joy. Remember the peace. Open the shades that are blocking out the past times of your life when God has moved from you. Open the blinds on the times that he's taken your hand and he's held your hand and he's led you through. Roll back the curtains. Roll back the curtains on the memories now and then. Open up the curtains to the Lord in your mind and let God shine in your life. Let the sun shine through. Remember what it felt to feel the presence of the Lord. Remember, mark it on your calendar. Send it as a reminder. Remember that day. To roll back the curtains, God. We thank you, Lord. Help us, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Roll back the curtains. Don't fear the enemy. Don't fear what's coming on the world. Don't be afraid of what's going on around you. Remember what the words that Jesus said. Luke chapter 21, verses 26 through 27. Men's heart failing them for fear, for looking after those things which are coming on the earth, for the powers of heaven shall be shaken. And when you see this, and when you see the Son, and then you'll see the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. And when these things begin to come to pass, remember, look up. Remember to look up. Remember to lift up your heads. For your redemption draweth nigh. Thank God so much. That's verse 28, and I forgot to give it to him. And when those things happen, begin to pass, then look up, lift up your heads. Remember to look up. Remember, you need to remember that when the world seems like it's falling apart, when it seems like everything's happening, when it seems like it's crumbling down around you, remember to look up. Remember when it seems like the enemy's taking over the world and all the evil is going on, remember to look up to the heavens. God, your redemption is drawing nigh. Remember where your help comes from. Remember to look to Jesus. Remember to keep your eyes on him. Remember that he will calm the troubled waters of your soul. Remember to remember. Remember, roll back the curtains on your memory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God told Israel, I don't want you to forget the things that I've done in your lives. I don't want you to forget. I don't want you to forget the miracles. I don't want you to forget the wonders. I don't want you to forget the deliverance. I don't want you to forget the times that I've been there when the enemy has been suppressing you and I came and delivered you. I don't want you to forget those things. I want you to remember those things when I was by your side, when I led you through the desert. I want you to remember when I was there for you. I want you to remember, even though you might have failed me, I still never left you. I want you to remember these things. I want you to remember the power that I delivered you with. I want you to remember. I want you to remember the power that I have to save. I want you to remember that I have the good that I have in store for you. I want you to remember the covenant that I have with Abraham. I want you to remember that the land is a promised land, and I'm the one that promised it to you. And if I said I'll do it, I will do it. I'll keep it. God encouraged him. Remember, because God remembers. God remembers. When Noah was on that boat, it had rained 40 days and 40 nights, and they're just floating around all day and floating around all night. No motor to take them where they wanted to go. There was no rudder to steer the direction. They went wherever God wanted them to. Chapter 7, verse 21 through 24. Don't bring it up, but at the Genesis, it ends with everything dying on the earth, every bird and cow, every man and woman, anything that breathed. And only Noah and those that were with him, they rode out. They were the only ones that were alive. They rode out on the grace that Noah had found in the eyes of the Lord. Only these remained alive. 150 days they were locked in that boat. All may have seemed lost. They hadn't heard from God for around 5 months. We've been out and about for, we've been doing our thing for 8 months, but we ain't been complete. I know y'all people, y'all ain't been locked in your house for no 8 months. Trust me, I seen you out and about. We ain't been locked in. But he was locked in that boat, and I'm sure the people and the animals were beginning to get on their nerves. They'd been fighting like cats and dogs, and even the cats and dogs were fighting like cats and dogs. But chapter 8 was a new beginning. It was a new beginning. Chapter 8, verse 1 says, and God remembered. Whew! God remembered Noah. God remembered every living thing and all the cattle that was with him in the ark. And God made a wind. God began to move. And a wind passed over the earth and the waters a surge. God rolled back the curtains. He took that string. He saw, oh, look there, I got a string tied around my finger. I see that sticky note. Don't forget Noah. He looked at it. He remembered Noah. He didn't just remember Noah. He remembered every living thing, all the ants and the flies and the mosquitoes and the cats and the dog. He remembered Noah's family. He remembered them, and he began to move for them. He began to move that ship, and he began to take it into the dry land. And God brought him to the dry land, and you know what? He promised. He said, I'll never destroy the earth again. Matter of fact, I'm going to make a covenant. I'll never destroy it again with rain. He said, I'll give you my word. He said, you know what? I'm even going to give myself a reminder. I'm going to give myself a reminder to make sure I remember this. Genesis chapter 9, verses 14 through 16. And it's come to pass when I bring a cloud over the earth that the bow shall be seen in the cloud. And then I will remember the covenant. God said, this ain't a reminder for you. This is a reminder for me. When I see the bow, when I see that bow, I'll remember my covenant, which is between me and you and every living creature and of all flesh. And the water shall no more become a flood to destroy all flesh. And the bow shall be in the cloud, and I will look upon it that I may remember. I'll remember that everlasting covenant between God and every living creature of all flesh that is upon the earth. God remembers the covenant. God remembers the covenant that he has with us. God said, when I see that rainbow, I'm going to roll back the curtains on my memories. I'm going to go back and I'm going to remember what I've done, that covenant that I made between me and every living creature. Man may have twisted the meaning of the rainbow, but not God, because God remembers. He ain't twisted it. It's the same thing. He remembers what he said. He set himself a reminder. God said, I don't feel bad about setting myself reminders now, because God had to. God had to set himself a reminder. I know it's okay for me to set myself in my mouth. He rolled back the curtains because God remembers. God told Israel, remember what I've done for you. He gave them feast days as a reminder of the different things that he had done for them. The Passover feast was a reminder to them that God passed over them. And he took the firstborn of every living thing in Egypt, and he saw the blood applied to the doorpost, and he remembered the promise, what I said, when I see the blood, when I see that applies to us today. When we see the cross, we're reminded of the blood that Jesus Christ, and it reminds him, when I see the blood, this time it ain't going going to be the death angel taking their lives. When God sees the blood in our lives, when he returns, he's going to take us to go be with him. When I see the blood, he's not going to pass over us this time. He's going to take us to be with him. He's going to remember what the blood means. He's going to take us up there. And I just thought about it while I was typing these notes out. I don't have a cross in my house to remind me. I've never put up a cross. And I'm like, God, I need to get a cross up in my... We got the cross here at church. I don't have one hanging. So I need a cross. I need a cross in my house to remind me, God, that when I look at it, I remember what the covenant, I remember what Jesus done for me. I look at it and I roll back the curtains in my mind and I remember it because it's God, it's his covenant with us. God gave Israel the Feast of the Tabernacles to remind them of coming out of Egypt and their dependency on the will of God in their lives. The Feast of Pentecost reminds the people of giving of the Torah and the first five books of on Mount Sinai and that they had committed to serving God. These things were done to remind them of what God had done for them and remind them to continue to serve God. God gave them reminders about the clothes, on their clothes to remind them about the laws of God. Numbers 15, 38 through 39 says, speaking to the children of Israel, bid them that they make them fringes in the borders of their garments throughout their generations. He said, from now on, folks, you got to do this. And they put upon the fringe of their borders a ribbon of blue. And it shall be unto you for a fringe that you may look upon it and remember all of the commandments. You're going to look down and you're going to look down at your clothes and your clothes are going to be a reminder. Make sure I keep the commandments of the Lord and to do them and that they shall not seek after their own heart and their own eyes after which ye shall use to go a-whoring. He said the way that you dress is going to be a reminder. It's going to be a reminder to keep the commandments of the Lord. They were not to see it as a burden. I know sometimes we see the way we're supposed to dress as a burden, but God says, no, this is a gift. This is a reminder to you. God was giving them something to help them to remember to keep the commandments. God wanted them to remember his commandments. He understood the frailty of the human mind, and he understood the inability of man to remember it. He said, you know what? I'm going to give you some feasts to remember. You're going to get to go out and party, and you'll have a good time. And you know what? It's just to remember the goodness of the Lord. It's going to remember all for you to remind them. Memorials, Thomas said on Wednesday, a reminder of all the good things that I've done for you. And that's why you go to tell your children and you tell everybody else about the Piedmont prayer and you remind them the goodness of what God has done for them. You remind them about prayer cloths. You remind them about God keeping the cancer out of church. You remind them about the Piedmont prayer. Don't share, when we share the link on with our friends on Facebook with church services, tell them about what those names are at the end of the service. Don't tell them, don't skip over those things. Remember what that's about. Your name might be on there. We want to remember those names because when we're faithful to that, we know that God will be faithful to us. Let them know. Remind them. God says, I ask you to make fringes to go on the borders of your garments so that you remember the commandments, so that you remember to do them instead of seeking after the things of your own heart. When you dress the way that God wants you to, remember, it's so you can keep God's commandments. You don't dress in a way to attract another man or attract another woman who you're not married to. You dress because you represent God. I represent the God that I believe in. I represent the covenant that God has made with me. And more importantly, the covenant that God has made with me and that I've made with God. Don't forget this. Remember that when you look in the mirror, you're looking at you say, that's because I serve God. Remind, don't let it slip to the back of your mind. Don't let it look. When you look in the mirror and you say, oh, I dress the right way, it's remember because it's a covenant between God. It's showing you that you represent God. Hear me. God, hear my voice tonight, God. Hear us, Lord. Remind the people. God, remind us, God. Roll back the curtains on our memories and let us remember why we said, God, we'll do this. Remember, you're representing the God of your salvation. You're showing the devotion to the Lord for the things he's done. And it's not a yoke. That promise that you made, yes, God, I'll dress this way, and you may no longer dress that way. Remember why you made the promise. Remember why you said I was going to do that. Go back and bring that back. It's no longer a yoke. It's not a weight tied around your neck. It's a promise that God has made you. It's a memorial for you to look to and say, me and God, we got something going on. Me and God, we got a thing. I dress like this because God's been good to me. I do this. Because God, I don't do this because God's been good to me. I do this because God's been good to me. Remember, it's a memorial. It's not, you consider baptism a yoke? Do you consider repentance a yoke? Do you consider the Piedmont prayer yoke? Do you consider calling up for the elders of the church or calling the pastor to pray for you before you go to a doctor's visit? Do you call that a yoke? No, you do that in remembrance that God can touch you and God can heal you. Why wouldn't we look at a reminder from God as something that's a yoke for us? God, roll back the curtains. God, remember, God, that the day it said, God, I won't do. You remember, church. Remember that day when you said, I won't do this or I will do that. I won't go this way. I won't walk that way. I'm going to do it. Roll back the curtains and remember what you said and remember why you said it.
That's right, amen.
God gave him a warning. God gave Israel a warning, a reminder of what would happen if they didn't remember. Deuteronomy 8:11-20. Beware that thou forget not the Lord thy God in not keeping his commandments. Don't forget it. And his judgments and his statutes which I command thee this day. Lest when thou hast eaten and art full and hast built goodly houses and dwell therein, and when thy herds and thy flocks multiply and thy silver and thy gold is multiplied and all that thou hast is multiplied, then thy heart is lifted up, and thou forget the Lord thy God, which brought thee forth out of the land of Egypt from the house of bondage, who led thee through the great and terrible wilderness, wherein were fiery serpents and scorpions and drought, where there was no water, who brought thee forth out water out of the rock of flint, who fed thee in the wilderness with manna, which thy fathers knew not, that he might humble thee, that he might prove thee to do thee good at thy latter end. And thou shalt say in thy heart, he said, don't forget this, because when you do, you're going to say in your heart, my power and my might of mine hand hath gotten me this wealth. But thou shalt remember the Lord thy God, for it is he that giveth thee power to get wealth. It's God that gives us the power to work and get the wealth, that he may establish his covenant, which he sware unto thy fathers as it is this day. And it shall be, if thou do it all, forget the Lord thy God, and walk after other gods, and serve them, and worship them. I testify against you this day that you shall surely, if you forget, you're going to perish. You're surely going to perish, as the nations with the Lord destroyed before your face. You so shall ye perish because you would not be obedient to the voice of the Lord your God. When you were poor and you were destitute and you needed him, you served him. And when you were sick and you didn't know why you were sick and you didn't know how to get better and the doctors couldn't figure it out, you needed him. So you served God. And when the enemy was attacking you and you couldn't fight him off by yourself and you needed God, so you served God. And God delivered you each time. God's been faithful to it. But now God's blessed you. Now you're relaxing. Now you're healthy. Now you've got safety on every side. Now you're making plenty of money. Life's gotten easier. But don't forget who got you where you are. Don't forget what got you where you are. Don't forget who brought you through. Don't let it slip your mind. Don't forget who brought you through these things. Don't let the good times fade your memory. Don't let the curtains close and you begin to hide God from your presence and you forget the promises that you made to God. Don't let the curtains cover the commandments of God. Don't forget. Roll back the curtains. Roll back the curtains on these things and remember. If you forget, and you take away all that you gave to God, your time, the time you used to give God your time, and you used to give God your energies, and you used to give God your talents, and now you give them to other gods. You give them to the idols of this world, and you forget and you do these things. Remember, God's going to destroy you. God's going to cause you to perish. He's going to pull that stuff back from you in a heartbeat, and you're going to lose everything that you had. Nebuchadnezzar forgot the warnings of Daniel. He had lived carefully for 1 year. But then one day he forgot. He forgot one day. He looked at everything that was around him and he said, look at what my hands have done. God had given him a warning. God had told him, Nebuchadnezzar, don't do this. Don't do this, son. I know it's in your heart. You have the ability to forget me. Don't forget me. Remember every day God had given him this. He knew the tendency. And every time he would see Daniel, you know it had to pop up into his mind. But then there was one day, maybe he hadn't seen Daniel in a couple days, and all of a sudden it just popped in his mind. And the blinds were allowed to be closed and the curtains closed on God. And all of a sudden he's like, oh man, look at all this stuff that I've done. And as soon as he did it, God pulled back everything that he had blessed. The warnings that God had given to him all of a sudden came back. And he lost his mind and he lost his prestige and he lost his position. And it was all taken away from him. And he didn't get it back until he looked up and he remembered. He didn't get any of that stuff back until he looked up and he remembered where his help came from. He didn't get any of this back until he looked up and he saw that it was God. God that was the one that provided and set things up and put things down. He didn't get it. He had to remember it. If he hadn't remembered, the curtains would have covered him up and he would have been lost. He would have been completely lost and he would have died out there in that field eating with those animals. I don't want to forget God, church. I don't want to forget the things that God's done for me. I don't want to forget who's brought me where I am today. I'd rather have nothing and have God and remember God and serve God than I would to have everything and forget God. I'd rather have nothing at all. I'd rather have absolutely nothing and remember that it's God who provides salvation, who provides provision and strength and courage, than to have everything that's out there.
That's right,
amen. Jonah was on the run from God. He was in the belly of the whale, and he was no doubt he was suffering. He's after three stubborn days, he decided he'd pray. He got rid of all the hate and he got rid of all the ill feelings that he had toward the people of Nineveh. And he remembered the one that he was supposed to be serving. He remembered the one. He remembered the vows that he had made. He remembered the only one that could get him out of the belly of that well. Jonah 2, chapter 7 through 9 says, "When my soul fainted within me, I remembered the Lord. When I fainted and I couldn't go nowhere else, I remember. And then my prayer came unto thee, Lord, into thine holy temple. They that observe lying vanities," church, listen to this, "they that observe lying vanities forsake their own mercy." When you observe, when you're into the vain things of this world and you're into yourself and you're into the houses and cars and all the other junks out there, you're forsaking your mercy. Let this preach to you this morning. You're forsaking your mercy. You're giving it up. You're letting it go because you're forgetting who God was. But he said, "But I will sacrifice unto thee with the voice of thanksgiving. I will pray. I will pay that I have vowed, because salvation is the Lord." He said, "I remembered, God, that salvation comes from you. And now I'm going to be the servant, God, that I told you one day I was going to be. I'm remembering, God, that one day, God, I remember that vow, God. And I've let vanity and I've let my ill feelings toward the Ninevites, I've let it forsaken my own mercy with God. But now, God, I remember. God, I remember you laid me flat on my back, God. I know I've been stubborn, God, but now I remember, God. And I'm going to pray to you, Lord. And I'm going to remember. I'm going to remember to pay my vows. God, I'm going to remember back to the day when I said I'm going to be your prophet. I'm going to be your preacher. I'm going to be your whatever Sunday school teacher. Whatever it was, I'm going to cut the grass. I'm going to clean. I'm going to whatever it is, God. I'm going to remember that day, God. And I'm going to remember and I'm going to do it. I'm going to remember the vows. Even with my ill feelings, I'm going to allow the curtains to close on it. I'm going to remember, God. I want to roll back the curtains on his goodness, and let me remember, God, where salvation comes from.
Amen.
And Jesus gave us a warning about remembering not to seek after the things of this life, but to remember to keep our eyes on the final prize. Luke chapter 17, verses 31 through 33. "And in that day he which shall be upon the housetop, and his stuff in the house, let him not come down to take it away. And he that is in the field, let him likewise not return back." Remember. Remember Lot's wife. "Whosoever shall seek after his life shall lose it. And whoso shall lose his life shall preserve it." Jesus said, use Lot's wife as a sticky note. Take Lot's wife and tie her around your finger. Let her remind. Set her up as a reminder on your phone not to look after the things that are after this world. Her body and her mind were leaving that place, but she still treasured her own life. She still treasured the things she left behind. She still counted it more valuable. The life that she left behind, she counted that more valuable than her salvation. Her treasure, that's where her heart was. That where your treasure is, there's where your heart is. And she left her heart back in that city. And she remembered where her heart was. And while she was preparing to escape from that world of the destruction, she left her heart back and she turned around and she was doomed. She lost it. Church, while you're preparing to leave this place, this place that's doomed from destruction, don't forget to leave your heart in this world. Don't forget and leave your heart in this world. Give your heart to Jesus. Give your heart to him. Don't leave it here. Don't leave it in your past. Bring your heart with you. Bring your heart. Bring your mind. Bring your soul. Bring everything with you. Don't leave anything behind and have to turn around and look back at it. "So I forgot my..." Don't do that, church. Instead, go with life this morning. Give your life to God. Give your heart to God. Give it all to him and look ahead to him. You're not taking any of this stuff out of this world with you. You're not taking one thing. One thing, you're not taking anything to occupy eternity, whether it's heaven or whether it's hell. Nothing here that's going with you. Not a car, not a house, not a phone, clothes, rifle, fishing pole, money. It's all going to be destroyed. And all of it's going to be destroyed. Don't be destroyed with it. Remember Lot's wife. Remember Lot's wife. Remember to leave it all behind. What the song says, leave it all behind. Just go to the well. Just go to the well where God is. Go to the well where Jesus sits and he's waiting for you to give you eternal life. Roll back the curtains and remember Lot's wife. We might forget God's commandments from time to time. We might forget about his commandments. We might forget about him. We might forget about the promises that we've made to him, but God never forgets about us. When Jacob was leaving Laban's house, he'd had his dream about the ladder that went to heaven. And God promised him that he would bring him back one day to his father's lands. He said, I'm with you, Jacob. I'll keep you in all places where you go. I'll not leave. I will not leave until I've done that which I have spoken to thee. And these same promises, that exact same promise applies to us. Hebrews 13:5 says, let your conversation be without covetousness. And be content with the things which you have. For he saith, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. Be content with what you have, church. Remember this. Remember that no matter where you are, remember that no matter what condition you find yourself in, that Jesus is right there with you. No matter where it is, he'll never leave you. He'll never forsake you. He's right there holding your hand. Jesus, hold my hand and take me through, because you're right there beside us. He's going to hold our hands and take us through the troubles and through the trials that we go through. He is there when you're surrounded by the enemy. He's there when you've lost your way. He's there when you've fallen down. He's there when you're getting back up. Jesus is always there. Just remember to look to him. Just remember to look to him. David said in Psalms 27:8, he said, some trust in chariots and some trust in horses. He said, but we're going to remember the name of the Lord our God. He said, I'm going to remember the Lord our God. Verse 8 says, they are brought down. He said, those people that trust in horses and those that trust in chariots, they're brought down and they're falling. He said, but we are risen. Those that remember the name of the Lord, we the people, we are risen and we go stand back up. We rise down. Proverbs 24:16 says it. I think Jonathan said it last week. For a just man falleth 7 times and rises up, but the wicked's going to fall in the midst of it. He only fall one time and they can't get back up. But the just man falls down and he gets right back up, because he knows where his help comes from. He knows, the just man, the just woman knows where their heart, where their help comes from. The wicked can't do this. When they fall down, they can't get back up. But remember, church, remember, if you're a just person, when you fall down, you can remember, oh, I've got Jesus. I got Jesus by my side. I got Jesus by my side. And he said, he'll never leave me. He'll never forsake me. I remember, roll back the curtains on that. We're able to rise again because Jesus is there. David remembered where his help came from. He knew brought salvation. He knew the blessings that came from remembering God. Psalms chapter 63:5-7. He said, my soul shall be satisfied as with marrow and fatness, and my mouth shall praise thee with joyful lips. When? He said, this, I'm going to be satisfied with the marrow and fatness, and my mouth is going to praise thee when I remember. When I remember thee upon my bed, and I meditate upon thee in the night watches. Because, God, I remember you've been my help. Therefore, in the shadow of thy wings, God, I'm going to be in the shadow of thy wings, God, and I'm going to be rejoicing. I'm going to be rejoicing. Hallelujah. Because I remembered thee upon the bed and in my meditations. The song, the chorus of the song that I take the title of this message from says, roll back the curtains on my memories now and then. God, show me where you brought me from and where I could have been. Remember, Lord, we're human and humans forget. So remind me, Lord. Remind us, dear Lord. Lord, help us, God, to remember where our faith comes from. God, when our faith is failing, God, let us roll back the curtains, God. When our walk is slowing down, God, help us to roll back the curtains, God. When the doctor's reports are not good, Lord, help us to roll back the curtains, God. When we're veering off the path and we're headed for destruction, God, help us, Lord, remember. God, help us to roll back the curtains, God. Help us to remember where we were. God, help us remember the covenants that we made. God, help us remember the feeling of your presence in our hearts and the Spirit, God, your presence, filling of the Holy Ghost, God, flowing through us, God. Help us to remember what we felt like and the power that we felt and the overcoming joy and the overcoming love, and we had the power of overcoming, God. Help us to remember, God. Don't let the church forget you, God, in this time of this pandemic, God. Help us not to forget you, Lord. Help us to remember, God. Help us to remember where you are and that we're there with you, God. Remember, God. Help us, Lord. Remember that there's life after this life, God. Remember that this eternity, that this is not eternity, and this is just a mortal life, God. This is just a short time, God. Help us to remember that this life is finite, and there's a hard stop at the end of it, but life still goes on after this body dies, that there is an eternity, God, and we're not living for this life, but we're living for the next one, God. Help us to remind us, Lord. God, help us to remember that we're living for that next life, God. Roll back the curtains, God, on our memories, God. Make your memories, God. Church, make the memories. Make your memories of God. Make it of God. Make memories of God and His mercies and His goodness. Make them precious memories. Precious memories. Oh, how they linger. Oh, how they ever flood my soul, God. The precious memories of the Lord. God, let your lingers, let your precious memories, God, of your goodness and the precious memories of your mercies and your grace and your joy and your loving kindness, God. Let it be precious to me, God, and let them linger in my mind and when I get up and when I go through the day and as I go to bed, God. Let me dream about them, God. Oh, let them flood my soul. God, let the precious memories of Jesus Christ and your love and your salvation ever flood my soul. God, church, you can't trust your memory. You can't trust it. You got to set yourself a reminder today. You need sticky notes. You need phone reminders. You need calendar reminders. You need fringes on your clothes. You need your what would Jesus do rubber bracelets. Whatever it takes, church. Whatever it takes to remember. Whatever, if you need a cross, whatever it takes to remember, church. Remember. Remember God. Don't forget Him again in this day. We ain't having service, but we're still having service, being able to do it online. Don't. But just because you're not in the building, don't forget God. Don't forget the covenants that you made with Him. Remember the one that's concerned with your eternal welfare. Take time now to roll back the curtains on your memories. Roll back the curtains, Lord, today. God, help us to remember to remember. Help the church, God. Help your people to remember to remember. Let's pray. God, we thank you today. God, we thank you, Lord, for mercy, God. We thank you for grace, God. We thank you, God. Help us to remember your mercy, God. Help us to remember your grace, God. Help us to remember your salvation. God, help us to remember that first time, that first day we prayed, that first day we got in contact with you. Help us to remember that feeling, God, that feeling of forgiveness, God, the feeling that you were there, God. Help us to remember, God, the power of the Holy Ghost that we felt, God. Help us to remember the cleanness that we felt with baptism. And if we need to go back in the hole of water to get it again, God, help us to remember what it felt like and we'll go back, God. Help us to remember, Lord. Help us to remember, God. Roll back the curtains on our memories. God, help us to pull up the shades, God. God, help us to open up the curtains, Lord. God, roll back the curtains, Lord Jesus, God. And help us, church, remember, God. Help us remember, God. Don't let us forget you in these days, God. Don't let the church, don't let the people forget you, God. Oh, God, we praise you, Lord. We thank you, Jesus, God. Bless the church, God. Bless us, Lord. God, we ask you, Lord, in Jesus' name, Lord. God, roll back the curtains. Roll back, church. We love you. We appreciate you. Remember, God. Remember all the things that you promised, God. Remember all the things that He's done for you, all His goodness. We pray for each of you. I hope you all stay saved, stay safe. We love you. We appreciate you. We miss you. And we hope to see you soon. I have what you need. But you keep on searching. I've done all the work. But you keep on working. When you're running on empty and you can't find the remedy, just come to the well. You spend your whole life chasing what's missing, but that empty inside, it just ain't gonna listen. When there's nothing can satisfy, and the world leaves you high and dry, just come to the well. All you thirst will thirst no more. broken. Just come as you are. When your last prayer is spoken, just rest in my arms a while. You'll feel the change, my child, when you come to the well. Now that you're full of love beyond measure, your joy's gonna flow like a stream in the desert. Soon all the world will see the living water is found in me, 'cause you came to the well.
Leave it all behind. Your fear of rejection.
Leave it all behind.